and welcome. I'm Peggy. And today we have two outstanding young people sitting here on the couch with us. And we also have the Greenville County Teacher of the Year. And I thank you all for giving us a little bit of your time. And Adam Scheich is Malden High School Band Director and Teacher of the Year.
Yes.
And I must say that it warmed my heart that they chose someone who's involved in the arts to be the Teacher of the Year. And I congratulate you.
It warmed my heart too.
And then we have next to him is Hannah Green. And Hannah is the student conductor. And what instrument do you play in special? Or
I play cello mainly.
That's one of my favorite instruments, a cello. Okay. And Turner Long, and you're both seniors.
Yes, ma'am.
At Malden High School. And you were a graduate of Furman, and then you have a master's in music education.
Music education, yeah.
That's wonderful. And you have wanted to be a teacher since you were in school.
When I was in high school, I taught middle school students the trumpet. And in the process of teaching middle school students, I realized that I really enjoyed that. And I decided in high school I wanted to be a band director. And so when I went to Furman, that was my course, and I stayed with it.
Oh, that's wonderful. And you have obviously, but you feel that this is more important than just teaching someone to play an instrument or march in a band.
Absolutely. Music is a lot of what we do, but it's, you know, in comparison to everything else, it's a small portion, because I really focus on teaching the whole child. We focus on what it takes to be successful once you have left school. So when they're in high school, I focus very much on the development of leaders. And to start, when they first come in their freshman year, we focus on them being able to follow directions. So that's your goal, follow directions your first time. And then your second year, we want them to master their skill. And by their third year, we start introducing small leadership, you know, menial responsibilities. And then by their senior year, we give them quite a lot of responsibility, so that it comes full circle where they start training the young people to do the same thing that they did, you know, 3 years before.
That's
that.
That's beautiful. And music encompasses so much more than just learning to play an instrument. I mean, there's math. There's a lot of things that play into being a musician.
Mm-hmm. I've always felt that the arts was the connective tissue to all the other disciplines. You know, we get to teach foreign language, a lot of Italian, and connecting that to other languages like Spanish. And, you know, we get to work on our science skills, the physics of sound, right?
Mm-hmm.
Today in my music appreciation class, I was able to talk about the rise of the middle class and its effect on culture and music in the classical period. So we get to hit everything from all around the school and pull it together and make it applicable.
And how many students in the course of, say, a week do you reach out to?
Well, I teach about 200 students a day. So,
oh my goodness.
5 days a week, I see them every day. I teach about 200 a day.
So you really become, you know these kids.
Very well, very well. By the time they graduate, it's funny because on the last day that we have our big picnic, our awards ceremony, I have a personal word message for each of them, and something that they've done or I've seen over the course of their 4 years that is just something just for them. So it's nice.
Well, I guess, Adam, I think this for you was a calling.
Yes. Yeah, I've always felt like God had a big plan for me, even from the beginning. And so, you know, I have felt like I have fortunately listened intently and followed that plan, and certainly has paid off.
And what are your plans? Are you going to have music the rest of your life?
Well, yeah, music's definitely something that will always be there. I mean, I love performing music, and it's a big part of my life as it is now. I mean, I could never do
but
without it.
But you want to go to Clemson, and you have dreams of, did you tell me pre-med? Did I hear you right? Bless your heart. Well, see, we've got these young people with big dreams, and our nation needs them.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And I want to ask you about your plans.
Right now, my plans are either to major in chemistry to go on to be a doctor of pharmacy, or to major in computer technologies and be a programmer or technician of some sort, with a minor in music so that I still have the ability to play for people or
That's
teach
wonderful.
Or go back to school for it if I would like.
So music will be a joy of your life, even if you don't earn a living with it.
Correct.
Yeah.
I enjoy playing my instrument. I enjoy playing multiple instruments and learning new music all the time. And it's become a big part of my life to where I can help other people feel the same joy that I get out of it.
Now, are you part of the marching bands that get out there and march?
Yes, ma'am.
That must be great fun.
Yes, ma'am, it is.
And you thinking about PC?
Yes, ma'am.
Presbyterian College. So we have Clemson and Presbyterian College represented here, hopefully.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you've got big plans and big dreams, and I think it's wonderful. I congratulate you because you're both seniors.
Yes, ma'am.
That's wonderful. And what you have accomplished is tremendous.
Thank you. I'm blessed to have great students that are willing to sacrifice a lot of hours and be willing to work really hard for me.
I want to ask you a key question.
Sure.
How much support do you have from parents? Because when I talk to people, a lot of times people in the education field feel that sometimes the parents aren't right there. And it's like a triangle. Mm-hmm. Education takes the professor or the teacher and the students and the parents. And if they all work together, it's a wonderful team.
Absolutely. I feel like it's important that we share our mission. You know, I want to make sure that our parents understand what our mission is so that when they see us doing things, they understand how what we're doing is aligned with that mission. And generally when we communicate, and I communicate very frequently, that's kind of the key, is making sure that everyone understands why we're doing what we're doing. And most people are willing to accept what we need. And I will send out frequent emails, hey, I need help. And I'm very fortunate that at Malden High School we have a very strong parent organization that supports what we
that's
do.
That's wonderful. Well, how many students total, not just the arts, but total, does Malden High School have? Do you know?
I believe it's right at 2,100 in
so
that
it's
area.
It's a pretty good size school.
Mm-hmm. Very, very good size school.
And you've been there for 11
This is my 11th year at Malden High School. I taught at Malden Middle School for 5 years before that.
So you've really had a career as 17 years of teaching.
Yes, this is my 17th year teaching. And right out of Furman, I started at a year in Charleston in the West Ashley area, and really enjoyed that. I had a mentor, her name was Debbie Jordan, and she took me under her wing. And, you know, I came out as that idealistic teacher that wanted to change the world, and, you know, it was great, and I had that vision. And she taught me how to take that vision and actually make it work with the students. And so that first year, she really made me a much better teacher. With her being a mentor. And then I left and came to Malden Middle the year it opened in 1999. So I was the first director at Malden Middle School. And I stayed for 5 years. I loved it. I loved middle school, but I missed some of the challenges of high school, you know, marching
well,
band.
There are challenges.
Well, there are challenges, but I missed the marching band, you know, atmosphere. I enjoyed that when I was going through school.
Yeah.
And I missed, you know, maybe that higher level of music that you know, you can do in high school that you can't necessarily do with first, second, and third year students.
Yeah.
And so I left at the middle school and left the middle school and went to the high school and have loved it.
What are your favorite, I mean, are you into classical music or band music or a little bit of both?
I'm definitely into classical music.
Good for you. So you're a Mozart lover.
Actually, Vivaldi.
Oh, well, that's not bad either. And what about you?
I enjoy any piece of music that he decides to hand me. I'll kind of play whatever I'm given. I don't mind, I just enjoy playing.
And you like to learn, have new challenges along the way.
Yes, ma'am.
You have been more than just a music teacher.
Mm-hmm.
What do you find? You've had strong relationships, building up your confidence and your ability with working with Adam, is that correct?
Yes.
I mean, he's been an influence beyond just playing an instrument.
I mean, of course, when I first met Mr. Shike, I was shy. I didn't want to talk to him. And I mean, now I have no problem. I mean,
obviously
talking
not.
To people. Or
well, that's wonderful. So he's enriched your life beyond just music.
Yes, ma'am.
And what about you, Turner?
I like to call Shike like a second dad. I got to know him really my eighth grade year. Towards the end, he'd come to the middle school and talk to the eighth graders about going into the high school program and not to quit it. And then starting in July, going into my ninth grade year, we started band camp, which is when I got really close to him as a director, because I like to ask questions and I like to figure out what I needed to do. And then going through, I just started going to him for advice, for school advice, life advice, what choices I should make, help with music, help with anything. I felt like I could just go to him for whatever I needed.
What a tribute from two young people to you. And when I talked to the people at the Greenville County Schools, they were full of praise for what you are accomplishing. And you plan to keep on teaching, don't you?
Absolutely. I would not want to give this up. This is a wonderful career.
And you have over 200 students a day?
Every single day. Yes, ma'am.
And high school students.
High school.
And you're still here, normal.
My first period class has 90 students in it. And one would think that, oh, it's such a large class, how do you get anything done? They are wonderful, and they work for me, and they're willing. They have great attitudes. They're willing to
do
everything.
Is this a choice that you make, or, I mean, it's not like you have to take English, you have to take math. You know, is this an elective?
Yes, ma'am.
So it's something you really want when you walk through that door.
Yes, ma'am.
Which makes a big difference, mm-hmm. doesn't it?
Yes, for all of us.
It makes it easier for you.
It does. You know, it's nice to have students that want to be there. You know, and of course there's some students that are questioning whether or not that's something they want to do, and we encourage them to just try it, especially that first year. And usually once they've tried it, they buy in.
Well, now, you had some knowledge of music and how to read music and the instrument before you ever came to Malden High School.
Yes.
I mean, you had lessons or?
Starting, we both went to Malden Middle School.
Okay.
Which was where he first started teaching. And there, when you go into sixth grade, you have a choice of a fine arts. You can take like a basic music class, chorus, strings, or band. So in sixth grade, I chose to do band and follow what my older sister had done and what everyone had praised. And I picked up my first instrument there, which was the trombone. And I played for 3 years and really enjoyed it under that director there. And then decided to move forward in it to progress my skills as a musician.
And you've planned that even though you won't make it as a career, you will have the joy of music the rest of your life.
Yes, ma'am.
And Hannah, what about you? What music did you study before you came to his class?
I was the same as Turner in sixth grade. You know, they tell you should pick an instrument, and I picked cello. And I actually didn't really meet Mr. Shike until my junior year.
Okay.
And so I started color guard my junior year, and I just loved it so much that I pushed myself to be more involved with everything that
the
band
does.
So
you played the cello, and you read music and all that before you ever came to his programs, which was a great help.
Yes, yes. At this point, we don't have a beginner's level course at the high school.
Okay.
So they do get their beginning level training at the middle school, and then we just take them at whatever level they start at, when they enter ninth grade, and we just push them from there.
Adam, as Teacher of the Year for Greenville County, which is quite an honor mm-hmm. in itself, you will go on to compete to be the Teacher of
South Carolina. Yes, ma'am. I'm working hard at that. Working on my application and putting together my schedule for appearances and discussions.
I would like to ask you, because what help or advice or words could you give out there, not just to students, but to parents?
I would say to the parents that we really do need their support in every way. I would really press upon them to understand that every teacher that I've ever met has the student's best interests in mind. We all have different ways of trying to accomplish what we're doing, but I find it important that the teacher that the parents understand the teachers really are trying to do what's best for the students. And rather than approach a discussion in anger, maybe sometimes it's easier to approach a discussion with questions to understand what's going on. Because the teacher wants the student to succeed. The parent wants the student to succeed. We both have the same goal. And the question is, can we work together to make that happen? And I think if the parents come in with that mindset, that we really do want to work together, it'll happen.
And most parents are supportive when you reach out and you need to talk to a parent about something that's going on, you find they're open-minded and want to be helpful.
Yes, I have found that's very much the case whenever I have approached parents. And, you know, part of it is for teachers, teachers have to understand that sometimes we make mistakes. And we have to be willing to own those mistakes. And hopefully the parents will give us enough grace so when we make a mistake that we can, you know, work our way through it. And it's not about us trying to be perfect. It's not about us trying to do, we don't make mistakes on purpose. No. But sometimes we do, and the teachers need to be able to own those mistakes, and the parents need to help us out in offering a little bit of grace. But at the same point, we are asking, you know, for the students to be responsible, the students to succeed, and the parents kind of help that process behind us.
And by the time you have reached a senior level in high school, you have accomplished, I'm sure, most of what Adam said. Thank you all for coming. Bless you in your future and your dreams. May they all come true. We're proud of you, and thank you.
Thank you.
Our South Carolina Teacher of the Year, Adam Scheich from Malden High School. We'll be right back.